Hello everybody, Dead Rafter here, and welcome to Sky Factory 2 Bacon Heart. Yes, because Bacon Donut, the creator of this modpack, has released a new version, Sky Factory 2. Actually, Sky Factory 2.2.2. This is the most updated version, and we're playing Minecraft 1.7.10, so big update to both the core of Minecraft and the modpack. Yeah, we have a lot of new mods to play with. I was very excited when I heard about it, and I decided to make a new series, new tutorials about this modpack that is super funny for me to play with and try to create crazy automations. And thanks to Bacon Donut that created this modpack, he put some new mods, some new interactions, let's say, and some very, very, very cool surprises. We're trying to take a look at them. Every tutorial we can try to explore and create something new. So bear with me. Let's start straight away. Funny mobs here. What is this? And yeah, let's go and create a new world. In fact, you will have to create a new world because the Sky Factory 1 world are not compatible with Sky Factory 2. Tutorial world 2. And let's pray. No more options. Everything is fine. Let's pray for planes. Some of the new mods include dual hotbar. You can see it. Taiga Hills. I don't know. Can it rain in a Taiga Hills? I'm not sure. So first we can see we have a minimap. You have to enable it. Press N and you will get the minimap. Press M. This is the default configuration, and you will get to configure the minimap. So I'm not sure if in the Taiga Hills it rains, but probably yes. But anyway, we have, as you can see already, some custom resource pack. Let me show it to you straight away. SF2 resource pack 3. This is included in the mod pack when you download it. You just have to enable it. But if you don't like it, just switch to default. I played a bit just to check what's new in this mod pack and what's new in this resource pack, and it's okay for me. I'll play with it. But yeah, you can choose whatever you want. Some addition to this mod pack, we can ride the dragon. Whoa-hoo. So there is a possibility to ride the dragon. I also enabled this mod pack that you can see in my hotbar, which is dual hotbar. I enabled vein miner and I enabled tails. I did not enable the infinite inventory because I don't know, it's unlockable in very inventory spaces with XP. I don't know, I'm not sure, I don't like it. So I did not enable it. But anyway, one, you can get the, with the pressure to pressing one of the numbers in your hotbar, you go to that number. If you press twice, you go to the upper hotbar. And it's also scrollable via the hotbar, and you can also configure it in the config file to have a single line instead of two rows. And let me just show you, taking inventory, good. The upper row in your hotbar is the upper row in your inventory. Nice, that's good. So we have a few books as usual. We have world domination, open blocks. We have materials and tools from Tinker, Tinker's Constructs, damn it. And we have this nice achievement book. So welcome to Sky Factory 2, a modpack by Bacon Donut. And yeah, yada yada yada, you can check all the information here. What's interesting for us is the challenges. In fact, you have something like an achievement checklist. Wood age, then you will have a stone age, farming age, exploration, machine age, etc, etc. So you can check your progress here with this book, don't lose it. And you can tick every option. So we're gonna tick these today, most likely. Not this one, probably, only the first. And let's move our books in the first row of the hotbar. And let's start. So what do you do the first day in a Sky Factory modpack, in a Sky Factory world? Well, first of all, let's grab one single block of wood. Let's transform it into a crafting table. And since we are super smart, we're going to use Thinker's Construct to make it a slab crafting station, and now we can put it down. But first we need a new one more block of wood. Yes, because we need a tool, a very important tool for this mod pack. That's called, let's put down this maybe. This tool is called a crook. Let's grab our four blocks planks of wood, and let's make four sticks. Arranging them in this fashion or this fashion, you have a crook. Well, this is a different texture from these for this tool, thanks to the mod pack, through the resource pack. And with this tool, very very important, we have a higher chance. Maybe some of you already know it, but we have a higher chance to get saplings. To get there you go, we got a sapling. Because if you don't get the sapling from the first tree, you're pretty much screwed, because you don't have the chance to plant another tree, and basically it's game over. You will have to create another world, do this all over again, and hope for sapling. But with a crook, just left click, see what I'm doing? I'm left clicking on the leaves. As you can see, the resource pack also give us the chance. Okay, now we can retain our crafting station, get all the wood, and keep digging down until we reach the dirt block that is underneath the tree, and keep using the crook. As you could see, now don't forget to press the shift key while you do this, because soon we will be standing on a single block of dirt. That's all will be left in our world. Scary, huh? Let me give you a nice view of our empty world in our block of dirt. Oh, that's super funny. I like this mod pack for this. So from this block of dirt, we can replant one of our saplings. We can put down our crafting station. So now we can move from our block of dirt. And we can create some more planks that we are going to transform into half slabs. So from 12 of those planks, we get 24 slabs, and we can extend our platform. I'm gonna do it and fast forward, because yeah, putting down planks, it's not super funny. So I will see you when I'm done placing down those planks. Okay guys, we are back, and we have a nice platform here in our empty world. At least now we can walk around a bit and feel a little bit safer. But don't forget to press shift as much as possible to crawl, so you will not fall down in the void and die. And now, as you can see, we have a torch here in our inventory. The mod pack creator kindly gives you a torch. And we also got this nice friend here, the silkworm, that we're gonna use probably in the next episode, we will see. Now, you can wait for this sapling to grow another tree, or you can twerk it. Let's press shift. Press shift, 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 and let's twerk this tree. You will see nice particles soon. Let me press F5. F1. There you go, twerk, twerk, twerk. This is like bone milling the tree. So the more the active you are next to your tree, and you have to be in the block next to it, the more the tree will grow faster. And as you can see, I'm pressing shift like a madman to apply some bone mill effect to my tree and try to grow another one without waiting one full day, or who knows how much we have to wait to grow another tree. That's very cool, that's very nice. It gives you something to do while you wait. You have to press shift, 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 left shift actually. And there we go, we twerked our first tree. And now we can do the same that we did with the first one, and keep doing it. But as soon as we have 8 sapling plus 1, we will stop this, and we will do something else. Actually, we will make a barrel. And this is probably something I want to do in this episode. So let's move forward and let's chop down this tree and get the saplings with our crook, like we did before. And as the sun is going down, I'm trying to twerk another tree to grow, because I didn't get enough saplings to make a full dirt block, because we need 8, but we need to save 1 to grow another tree. So hopefully this will grow. Oh no, I thought it was a super huge one. And the moon is rising. face moon. And let me show you something thanks to another mod in this mod pack called Vein Miner. If you press Grave, the default button, and controls should be Grave. Vein Miner, yes, it's Grave. And I don't know, it worked before, but now it's not working for me. But with Vein Miner, you should be able to chop all the leaves at once thanks to this mod. I enabled it because it's in the mod list in the controls. That's weird. Right mouse button, left, right. I'm a bit disappointed. I will double check this again, and we will do it in the next episode with our next tree. But anyway, now we have 11 saplings and an apple as well. So we can do the magic of Ex Nihilo Barrel and create another dirt block. That's probably Bacon Donut face in the moon, or the resource pack creator face. So let's chop down the tree, the wood, and let's put down a new sapling. Now, since we have 10 saplings left, we can create the barrel. Let's go over the crafting station. Let's convert all these wood logs into planks. Let's make some more slabs. And if I'm not mistaken, we can check NEI, not enough item, barrel, and see how to make an oak barrel. Yes, 6 planks and 1 slab. So 6 planks on the side and 1 oak slab. And we have our oak barrel. Now, with this tool, you may remember how to use it from Sky Factory 1, but simply you just put inside compostable items. In this case, we're gonna use 8 saplings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And as you can see, there is a nice affecting Waila. What am I looking at? This tooltip in the top side of my screen that tells you collecting material 87.5%, 100%. So now it's composting, and we're gonna wait for composting to reach 100%. Meanwhile, the texture will go from green to dark green, light green to dark light brown, and so and so on and so on until it's completely brown. And we have our dirt block, our additional dirt block, so we can twerk 2 trees at once. That's nice, huh? Let me skip this for you guys. And the first day is also ending soon, but for the first day we achieved a lot. Sorry for the long tutorial, but it's an introduction, so I had some talking to do. Next tutorials, they will be shorter, hopefully. We will see more things. Overall, so I didn't have to move forward because, yeah, the dirt is ready. Right click and you collect your dirt block from the barrel. Now let's move a bit. This second we are going to put it, yeah, this side, that's okay. Let's move a couple of more blocks, so the 2 trees, they do not, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. The 2 trees, they do not interfere with each other. And can we do this? No, probably not, because I'm standing on the block. So there we go. Second dirt block placed. And I'm gonna extend this platform off camera. But this will be all for today, guys. Let me check the moon. Where is the moon? Ah, it's exactly above me. Okay, it doesn't matter. So let me hold my crook, which is a scary what's called claws. But yeah, we achieved a lot in this first episode. We talked about the new mod pack, what's in it, a few sneak peek of what has been added by Bacon Donut. We chopped our first tree successfully and we planted it again. We learned how to twerk it. We made another dirt block so we can grow more trees, so you can repeat this process all over the as long as you want. And yeah, thank you very much for watching. Consider subscribing to keep updated with these fantastic Modpack video tutorials. And yeah, check the links in the description to know everything about AT Launcher, Sky Factory 2, and so on. And I hope to see you next time. Ciao, ciao.